We have t-shirts in 7 inches in the back. One of these songs is on a 7-inch. Thank you. that we're putting out on Huntington Records at the time of spring. We also have a split coming out, 8.0 from Connecticut. So get it. You think so?
White trash. Sorry, excuse for a beard.
Thank you. the last one.
We have shirts and stuff in the back.
Shirts and stuff in the back. Last song. This one goes out to Hold Strong. So we're an awesome bunch of guys.
Thank you. Thank you. The band Harvest has made it. So we're only gonna play a couple more. Hope those guys get out. This one's called It All Starts Here. Sing along. Thank you. much.
Thank you.
everyone who set this up. Last time we were here about summer of 96, I believe, with Despair and Brothers Keeper in Northampton. Had a great time there. Had a great time here. Massachusetts ruled. We're on a East Coast tour right now. It's a short 1 week and a half. But from Minneapolis, you know, makes it a long trip. But it's nice to be away from home for a while.
Hold on.
Just go.
You're just catching me by surprise.
All right.
Thank you.
had a few member changes in the past 2 years. We now have a new bass player, it's Jonas. Those of you who've seen us last time. And we have a guy, Adam on drums, who's been filling in. And we're recording a new EP come March, I believe, with a few new songs. And we'll play one for you right now. The song is called Epic Killer. See if it gets your approval. March on Trust Kill Records called Living with a God Complex. And before that we had a 7-inch out there
Incision!
Called Incision. Yeah. We're gonna do a couple songs off that. Actually, yeah. There are only two on it anyway. But we'd like to play them for you. Thank you. I think it's finally seen its last legs.
Well,
we did a 5-week tour with Endeavor last summer and really think that almost killed it, but we still have it, so maybe it'll go on a mantle one day. But Mike has saved us, and I'd like this song to go out to him. Without him, we'd be here. This song is called Waterfall. So as you know the words, I encourage you to sing it.
I'm
Thanks a lot. That was...
Thank you.
you can put the punching and the kicking away for the night. Treat each other with a little bit of respect and compassion. Move up, sing along, have some fun. This is not a band that wants to incite violent feelings.
I'm not going.
Oh, I lost my hat. I want to say a few words about Harvest. This is the first time that I've gotten to play with one of my favorite bands. They've been one of my faves since I saw them play that show with Pearl Street a couple of years ago. I honestly don't think a tighter, more brutal band has been on this stage. I mean that. I've seen a lot of shows here. And they were just straight up ferocious. The third thing I want to say about them is how fucking awesome I thought it was. I don't know if y'all saw, but they had a group hug before they started to play. They all embraced each other. And it just really, it takes that tough guy thing away from what they're all about. Because their music is brutal, but it's clear when you see that that stuff's not in their heart, hatred and violence. That was the nicest thing I've seen a band do in a while. This song goes out to them. It's called Every Effort Made. I can still see the reasons why I opened my eyes to the scene in the first place, and I can still feel my beliefs growing stronger. And I can still count the ways. I can still count the ways. Yeah. Want to come up here, but you're welcome, and you will not be hurt. You can come up, get involved. You don't have to stand for hero. Look at all people that are still trying to do what's right.
I don't like this.
This is the first song that I wrote for this band. It's called Lay the Blame. And it has a whole lot of meaning to me. It's not, I repeat it, it has nothing to do with straight edge. Or it's not an anti-drinking song, it's not telling anybody else what to do, how to live. It's a totally personal song about the way alcohol abuse has affected my life personally over and over again. Every line of it has something to do with something I've seen or gone through. My grandfather, my earliest memories of him were him passed out drunk at my mother's house after being kicked out of my grandmother's house. I had a friend drive a car into a tree in Florida, killing everyone in the car. He was drunk. My mother was a heavy drinker throughout her life. She died of liver cancer a few years ago. It's kind of hush-hush that, you know, alcohol and smoking abuse was what did it, but that's what I believe. And the hardest thing was one of my best friends ever shot himself in the head while drunk. So when I had to sit down and pen lyrics for this band, the first thing that came out of me was this rage of me having stood idly while all this craziness went on. How it all ended bad. And I had to deal, you know, I had to stand there and deal with it. It's not saying not to drink. It's just saying that maybe if you see things getting fucked up, you might want to step in and tell the person, put a hand on their shoulder. I mean, my uncle was at my grandmother's house this Christmas Eve, smashed, and I couldn't intercede. It's a hard thing, you know, to have to get involved personally. I have to step in and tell an adult what to do. It's hard. So this song, Lay the Blame, is just trying to deal with that. Just trying to say that there is something to pin the blame on. People don't want to recognize it, don't want to talk about it. We here in this hardcore community that's really involved in straight edge, you know, we kind of see it, but a lot of people don't. So that's what this is about. Thank you again. Can't thank you enough. Ben,
Crazy. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.